beautiful Gemini friends, and welcome to your horoscope for September of 2020, where this month, Gemini, I really love the fact that we start out with a moon that's happening at the top of the chart. And as we close out the month, we're having a moon that's happening at the bottom of your chart. There's a lot going on in the middle of the month in different houses for you, but these moons are actually completing a cycle of work and home for you that I think has probably been a long time coming. So I look forward to telling you what I see coming in that area. As well, this month, the autumn equinox gifts are out. So click in the description box down below. You can take advantage of them, and they are, of course, first come, first serve. As well, this month stays fire with the Eat and Greets. We've got Becca Tarnas, fellow YouTuber Athan Chimenti will be here talking about sidereal astrology. We've got Michael A. Bryan coming over. Gary Caton will be back to get us ready for Mercury retrograde next month. I believe Rick Levine is making an appearance, Christina Caudill. So just lots and lots going on in the Eat and Greets this month. And remember, with the Eat and Greets, you can always catch them live here on YouTube. You can watch them back here on YouTube, and you can also catch them now on the Stormy Grace podcast as well. So check in the description box down below for all of those goodies. All right, Gemini, let's peel this little month of an onion that we've got going, okay, and see what's happening for you. So right at the beginning of the month, on the 2nd, we're coming in with the full moon happening at 10 degrees of Pisces. Now, this is the tip top of the chart, so in the midheaven, the 10th house, career, work, soul level calling, what you have to give in the world. But also in the 10th house, I like to put what we know you as. For example, if you were single and you were getting married, or you were single and you're getting into a committed relationship, we start to know you by a different title. So as you're thinking about your life this month and how does this relate, are you changing a title in some way, shape, or form? Did you go from just coming into the company and now you're known as something else, right? What do we know you as? So think a little bit broad when we're talking about this 10th house area for you. Now, the full moon says that something has to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted. So one of the things that I feel like Pisces energy asks us to do is to stop suffering, right? It's like, stop suffering. Hold on. Where are we suffering? The full moon's going to shed a whole bunch of light over different areas of our lives in regards to our career. And it's going to say, are we suffering here? Where do we need to surrender a little bit? Surrender to win here. Where are we willing to allow some transitions to happen under these particular energies? This light that comes under this full moon is going to show you, you've been working on something for a while. Now, at this point in the cycle, it's like it's time to let it culminate or adjust it so that you can see what it's going to be and what it's going to do next. It's a really lovely kind of energy, okay? On the 5th, we see Mercury moving into the energy of Libra. Now, this is going to light up your 5th house space. Mercury is our planet of thinking, communication, decision-making. So he comes into the energy of Libra, which is air. So Mercury quite likes moving here, actually. But what's going to happen is that in your 5th house, the house of joy, expression, self-communication, children, romance even, you're going to start to think a little bit more balanced. There's a lot more diplomacy here in all kinds of relationships, especially Libra likes conscious one-on-one relationships. So where have you needed a little bit of diplomacy, a little harmony in your business relationships? Let's say that you're starting something new, right? Because the 5th house is a beautiful place to begin, to conceive something, or if you have your own business, to take it to a different level or in a different direction. Plus, we just had a full moon. What have you seen just in this handful of days? Mercury here is going to help you be diplomatic. It's going to help you be savvy in the negotiations that you're making. It's also a really good energy, I think, to discover any artistic skills or any creative angles you can come at things within this area. Okay, some of you, not one or two of you, I'm seeing some of you this time are definitely going to be having some romantic conversation, or you are having like a romantic thought of somebody or something that you love. But a couple of you, this is specific to having a conversation with a romantic conversation with people. So I look forward to seeing who of you that is in the comment section down below. On the 6th, we see Venus leaving the 2nd house, where it's very much so at home, moving into the energy of Leo. So now lighting up your 3rd house. The 3rd house is our thinking, our communication energy, the house of the mind. We study, we make websites from here, we write books. Perception lives in this house. As Venus comes into the energy of Leo, of course, Leo is creative. Vibing with this Venetian energy, it's like, well, luxury and joy. And how do I take this to the next level? How do I make this feel good, taste good, look good? Where is the creativity breaking through in this area? If you've been stuck and stumped on a creative project, or maybe you're writing a paper or a class, or you've been trying to study something and it's like it's just not sinking in, Venus definitely works her harmony magic here as well to bring you a little bit of help. Now, the other thing I want to say, Venus moving out of your second house is not a cause for panic and concern, because Venus moving out of your second house means that essentially for the rest of the month, besides the moon running through your second house, it's empty, which is actually a signal that it's just status quo. Things kind of stay as they are. There's no big bumps. There's no big drops in the financial arena. So that's something I just want to kind of bring your mind to. On the 9th, we're going to have Mars heading into retrograde now until November 13th. Okay. Now Mars is going to take this retrograde starting out at 28 degrees of Aries and going to end it at 15 degrees of Aries. So track that in your chart, okay? Mars's retrograde through Aries is going to light up your 11th house space. So this is friends, organizations, acquaintances, social groupings, but also your long-range goals and desires. Mars is our planet of desire. He's your human doing. What do you want? He's your hustle when you decide that you want something and you go towards it, right? So what's happening here as Mars is retrograde is, one, you are re-looking at the action and the time and the energy, and do you have the desire to hang out with certain friends, be tied to certain organizations? Does that long-range plan, is that thing that was your dream for a very long time, does it feel like the right dream for you now at this point in your life? Also, because Mars is our hustle energy, in your 11th house, you may not be feeling extraordinarily social this month either. You might be like, okay, I need to take a step back for a minute. I need to see where I fit here. Does this fit me? It's under revision is what's happening for the next handful of months. So as you are trying to get things done, I want to just tell you this, especially if you are a content creator, you're doing something social, you're even just taking the kids and dropping them off at school, or you're doing it online, whatever the social component is in your life, you may find yourself under a little tension, especially as Mars is trying to stay or turn into his retrograde energy. So if you find yourself feeling a little tense around, you know, the 9th, 10th, even 8th, 9th, 10th of this month, and then as we get into November, you're finding yourself feeling a little heated or a little tense, the stationing is really hard. That's when we get a lot of the intensity of the energy. That will pass, and it's just asking you to review the actions and the desire that you have in these certain arenas, okay? On the 13th, Jupiter is going to come out of retrograde and be direct again in the energy of Capricorn. Now, he's going to be direct at 17 degrees of Capricorn, okay? So this is up top, lighting up the 8th house space for you, which is, one, about making sure that you are interdependent, not codependent, right? So it's going to ask you, even though it's a joint house, it's really going to ask you how you're standing on your own. There has been a lot with this Capricorn transit of Jupiter, Saturn, and Pluto here that I think has asked you a lot, Gemini, about your connections in standing alone from your family, or standing alone from your foundation, right? Like, what is your foundation to build on? And you've been making some changes in this area as well. As well, it's just also another financial house. So as Jupiter is out of retrograde here, I think one of the things he has asked you to do during the retrograde is look at the wisdom of what you can do for yourself to expand. It's been an energy that said, do you have the necessary skills to really expand in this area of your life? It's certainly been an energy of cutting away things psychologically that don't fit anymore, that have been more of a weight to you than they have been to help you fly and expand. I think it's also, as Jupiter is direct this time, Gemini, it's really this solid understanding of what you need in order to expand and to meet your goals. This is a time where Jupiter has been going through this 8th house for you for some time and has given you strength, perseverance, and endurance in this area of your life. So this could certainly be, as Jupiter's out of retrograde, if you had an inheritance, a collaboration, a healing coming, and it felt like it was coming very slowly. All of those things come forward as Jupiter is direct now, and it feels like it's happening a lot more quickly, or that it's just happening now, finally, right? When we get to the 17th, we've got a new moon happening in Virgo. So down at the bottom of your chart, this is going to be at 25 degrees of Virgo. Now we had that full moon to start the month in the 10th house. And now as we come to the end of the month, we've got this new moon where you're going to plant these seeds of intention in the fourth house area, home, family, real estate, property. So Virgo is analytical. Right? But Virgo is also an earth sign. So it is a mutable earth sign. So I think that at this particular new moon, you can really find something around your housing or around your family starting to take root. But what Virgo would have done here is advocated for you to really use practical analytical skills to get this done. Almost like Virgo is like, okay, hold on, let's stop, let's take a look if we're on course, if we're on track, if this makes sense. And Virgo is as an earth sign going to say, in my material reality, does this living situation, does this house, does this family connection make sense? And you also get to plant your seeds of intention at this particular moon for things to go ahead and take that earthy root so that you can land where you want to, whether it's psychologically or whether it is in an actual home, and you can kind of ground down, root down, and grow from this particular area. So plant those seeds of intention around this Virgo moon. Also, we'll have Neura coming over and we're going to be talking about the moons of the month. So look forward to that as well. On the 22nd, we've got the sun entering into the energy of Libra. This again lights up your fifth house up there with Mercury. Now, what we've got this month is the planets in mutual reception. We've got Venus in the energy of Leo, and we've got the sun in the energy of Libra. Because Venus rules Libra and the sun rules Leo, these are what we call in mutual reception. They're happy to be working together. They're happy to be lighting up each other's homes. So this is a lovely energy, and we can see how they interact with each other. So one of the things that we see is the sun lighting up this fifth house of Libra brings light, heat, life, and vitality. You are motivated in your relationship, your conscious chosen one-on-one relationships. And this also includes the things that you are in relation to, the things that you are related to. So during this particular cycle, the influence that Venus brings into the sun, but that also we see that connection with Leo here, what we see is that there is a creativity available in your relationships. I almost, for somebody, I'm seeing you are developing a character of some variety. Is this the character that you're ready to present? Is this a character in a book? Is this a character you're going to do something with? Are you developing a website? What is this? This is you are in development of a character of some variety here, or development of an art here. So these two energies will work very well together. But either way, the sun moves into the energy of Libra, and we start to see new relationships that are able to either get new life to them, or it is just a new relationship that's able to come into your life. Of course, the fifth house points you to look at children as well. So joyful things, or your actual children themselves. So that's a beautiful energy. The 27th, we see Mercury entering into the energy of Scorpio, now starting to light up your sixth house. Mercury in Scorpio is not shallow. We want nothing shallow here. You become a very good observer, observer of your health, observer of your routine, your habits, your thinking. You're going to be really closely tied to that. As well, Mercury in Scorpio here, if you are working on projects, you're going to be working in the depth of the project. There's something really juicy down there, and Mercury is going to help you sift through those energies. So, and especially relationships, health of relationships is something that I'm seeing for you this month as well. So really pay attention to that. Well, that would make sense as well. You've had Jupiter and Saturn comes out of retrograde in this eighth house. Scorpio is a natural ruler of the eighth house. Truly, what is this connection, Gemini, with your family or with things that have felt like family or roots for a very long time? Let me know about that in the comment section down below. What are you finding some independence here with? Oh, totally interested. Okay, as we close out the month on the 29th, Saturn is coming out of retrograde in the energy of Capricorn, also at 25 degrees here. So what we're going to see as Saturn is out of retrograde, he's been working through this eighth house for a couple years now. Nothing new, nothing shocking. As he went into retrograde, he said, did you learn the lessons? Have you learned and crystallized what I was trying to teach you? Have you focused on your career? Have you focused on your independence? Have you focused on your healing? Have you focused on your astrological studies? Now, as Saturn is out of retrograde, Jupiter's out of retrograde, and we'll meet Pluto out of retrograde next month. What we find here is focus driving you forward in these areas. focus and self-discipline. You have it now. It doesn't have to be pushed on you. You have it, and you're going to be able to appreciate your skills to do all of these eighth house things, joint resources. You know, has your partner, because this is a joint place, has your partner gotten more firm, come to another level of maturity, or something is improving? There's a level of discipline and mastery in this area that would be showing up as Saturn comes this way. With Saturn and Jupiter out of retrograde, things can definitely this month start to feel like they are moving forward, even if it is still quite slowly, okay? All right, Gemini, I think it's going to be a good month. I look forward to seeing what is this creative character that some of you seem to be developing. And on the romantic front, please let me know if you are in that some people that came up. I would love to know what's happening for you, okay? All right, you guys, like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I look forward to seeing you in the autumn equinox appointments. And I look forward to seeing you in the eat and greets as well. Bye, Geminis.